And so what is this idea of complexity? So we sort of intuitively know when something is complex, but I want to offer you a couple of different ways to look at it today. So two definitions. One of them is cause and effect, or the degree to which cause and effect is linear, and we can kind of see what the cause is and what the effect is when it's obvious, and whether or not we're able to see it ahead of time. So when things get more complex, they're not linear, it's not obvious maybe how cause and effect are connected, and we're not necessarily able to predict it ahead of time. We might be able to see it in hindsight. And so one of the examples I'd like to use of this is 9/11. When 9/11, immediately in the aftermath of 9/11, it was very chaotic, right? We really didn't know what had happened, and it took us a long time to figure out what the causes had been that led to the effects that we experienced. So that's an example of something that even goes beyond complex into chaotic. Another way of thinking about complexity is this idea of problems and polarities. And so much of how we think about challenges that we face is that they're problems to be solved, and that once we deal with them, they're done and we can kind of move on. But when things get more complex, what they really are dilemmas to be managed. They're not problems that are going to be solved. And so an example of that is I do a lot of coaching with leaders who bring up work-life balance, right? There's probably not anybody who hasn't had a thought about work-life balance at some point. And the trap that we fall into is thinking that if I solve the problem of work-life balance, then it's done, I'm set. When really it's a polarity, it's a dilemma. I have work and I have life, and I want to maximize the benefits of both of those things and minimize the disadvantages of both of those things. So it's a really more of a polarity that I need to manage over time, as opposed to a problem that I'm going to solve and be done with it, right? And so when we think about the world getting more complex, business getting more complex, we're kind of talking about either cause and effect or this idea of polarities. So I just want to give you a quick taste of, like, okay, when we talk about complexity, what do we mean? And the impacts of this complexity that we see more and more are pretty significant. So IBM runs a study pretty frequently. I don't know if it's every year or every other year, where they survey CEOs, and 80% of the CEOs in their study report that complexity is the single biggest issue that they face in their business. Henley Business School reports that $237 billion of profits are lost annually by the top 200 companies in the US due to complexity. And on a personal level, when we are in over our heads, when we are experiencing more complexity than we can individually handle, we experience stress. And we know that, you as HR professionals, we all know that stress is a huge epidemic. The World Health Organization is saying that this costs American businesses up to $300 billion a year. So I want to, you know, sort of put forward this idea that complexity and change are a significant issue with significant implications, and it's something that leaders are thinking about.